Well, here we're going to talk about the credit card slavery and how they control you. The Illuminati, or the credit card companies, or the government, or the financial institutions, or all the people that want to control you. And if you have been listening recently, Alex Jones, or some of the oldest, like the grandfather, or the grandfather and the grand thing, Jordan Maxwell, for example, is a very clever guy. By the way, we're back here in Masters in Accounting. This is Howard Beach, JFK. We're in Howard Beach, JFK, and I want to talk about, this is open air, I'm far away, I'm hiding, you know, as you can see, I'm hiding all the time from some expert or some authority that will come and tell me. By the way, I don't have legally rights to do this video right here on the open space, but I'm trying my heart. So now, if you have been listening these conspirators like Jordan Maxwell's and all these freedom fighters and the people that are all these movements, net neutrality, the Bitcoin community is also fighting, the Bit community, the Bitcoin community is fighting for freedom, but it's a lot of things are messed up in the Bitcoin community. Anyway, let's get back to the one little detail. I don't want to explain you how all these things works. This is like a very, very big iceberg, and you cannot even see the tip of the iceberg, or you cannot see the big picture. But I'm here to tell you about these little things. These are so-called patterns that I noticed that they directly affect your life, how they control you. For example, do you know that in the United States of America, if you don't have a credit card, you cannot rent a car. You cannot rent a car if you don't have a credit card. Or if you don't want to use a credit card. Now think about this. You might think, well, that's how things work. Of course. That's right. If you don't have a credit card, you are generally, well, you are a failure. But let's say if you have a credit card and you don't want to use it, well, somebody somewhere all the way on the top of the chain, government, but higher than the government, the credit card company, they decided to make this official. And it has been recently for the last couple of months, but now it's December 25th or 26th, 2017, and I'm here to tell you that if you don't have a credit card, you cannot actually rent a car. No, you cannot use the credit card of your friend, of your husband, of your wife. You cannot use a credit card. You cannot use bitcoins. You cannot use cash. Why is it that? Well, the reasons are big. But let's hear my point. First of all, these credit card companies are trying to perpetuate their business, which is the credit business, which is a fiat business. And the more you participate in this credit card game, the more they gain power over you. So now, soon they're gonna limit you. You cannot have electricity without credit card, not by debit card. They're gonna say, well, you know, they're gonna talk to Con Edison and they're gonna convince Con Edison that it's good to take your life ahead of time. My credit. That is what is called in some of the books from the old fathers of the conspiracy theorists and stuff. That is called control by design. Very clever idea. I like this idea. Control by design. Sorry for the video, it's not so good. But yeah, they design the system. Like Google is designing the system to control you. Their system, like the Android system, this is a system, a platform, any platform, there is a level of control. Netflix does it too. For example, just to give you a little bit of idea, have you noticed that some of the videos in YouTube are playing automatically? It's like a playlist. That's a good thing for the... But they want your attention for more time. You want to stay more time in YouTube and not have a life. Well, good luck. but watch my videos only. Understand how these things work. So now let's get back to the credit card. Why the credit card have a leverage over a person? I mean, like, over you. They dictate how you're gonna make a payment. In other words, they tell you, we are the currency. We are the prime source of money. It's a credit. It's not money, it's not cash, it's not bitcoins. We are the masters of the universe. And we tell you that you don't have credit with us, you are deprived from basic freedoms to purchase. Like, this is a freedom, you know, one of the freedoms in America. You can purchase anything you like. You have $500 cash, okay, you rent a car. You have $5,000 cash, hey, you rent a car. Not so many companies accepting cash. Strange. No, any company in the car rental business is accepting bitcoins. Strange, right? Because let's get to another level. Why is that? You know why? Because who do you think owns these rental companies? I mean, like the big one, you name it, Enterprise, Avis, what are they, Hertz, who do you think owns them? You think some guys, like some smart guys, board of directors? No, the same people, the credit card companies. Now, there is a science for that. Have you noticed that they always use brand new car? So you go to Hertz and you have the latest model, 2000. If you rent in 2017, you most likely will get a car 2018 from the future. They get car from the future and they give it to you. But how they get this? How they always, you know, it's simple. In their business, it's very simple. They get new cars for free by credit. You know, they use leverage. Good word to know. They use the leverage, and the 2016, they sell it for the highest price, for the highest bidder. There's auctions and stuff, and they sell it. But, well, there is a price to pay on that. When they borrow this money in millions of dollars, these are the companies that gives them the money, they set up like a little rules. Like, one of the rules is, hey, you cannot take people's debit cards. See? You see now the big picture? I hope you see the big picture. I hope you know how it works. So, this fight between these big companies, it's one little nail in your pocket. And my train is coming, and we're gonna continue this video. That's a very interesting topic. And we're gonna continue. I hope you like that stuff. Keep listening, get smart, and I wish you well.